We are students. In the last class, we already discussed the software concept. So that is, what is software? So what are the types of softwares? And what is translator? And what are the types of translators, linkers, loaders, and operating system? So today we are discussing the concept that is operating system. Okay. So here operating system is nothing but the it is the interaction between the user and the computer. Interaction between the user and the system. When you switch on the computer, when you start the computer, so automatically it will shows the Windows 7. Suppose if it is a Windows 7, directly it shows Windows. If it is a Windows 10, again Windows. Okay, so that the example for operating systems are Windows. Windows 7, Windows XP, Windows 8.1, Windows 10 are the versions of Windows operating system. Another one is Unix operating system. That is Linux. Linux is one type of operating system. And Fedora, again it is an operating system. Windows, etc. There are n number of operating systems are available. Okay, so here operating system means it is an interaction between the user and the system, and this operating system will manage the hardware components. And this operating system has to perform several functions. There are n number of functions are there. The first one is memory management. So you already know that what is memory. So here memory is nothing but it is a storage area. So again in memory there are two types. First one is primary memory, second one is secondary memory. So the example for primary memory is RAM. That is random access memory. The example for secondary memory is hard disk. So this memory can be managed by the operating system. So here memory management means, suppose if you are creating the any file, either it may be the Word file or either it may be the Excel file, either it may be the programming file. So whatever it may be the file, it occupies some space. For example, the hard disk consists of 1 TB. Again, 1 TB is divided into the sub partition, that is C drive, D drive, E drive, and F drive. So each drive consists of some capacity, some memory. For example, if I want to save the copy from 151 drive, that is external drive, to the D drive. Okay. So this operating system will allocate the memory for your file. For example, the file consists of 100 MB. So the 100 MB will be occupied, this file, that can be managed by the operating system. Suppose if you want to delete the any file, again that memory will be free. Again that can be managed by the operating system. And this operating system will keep track of the every memory, either it may be the primary memory or either it may be the secondary memory. The secondary memory is mainly used for storing the data. If you want to use the files in future, so compulsory you can save the file, that can be stored in secondary memory. But primary memory is only for execution purpose. For example, if you want to execute the instruction or if you want to execute the any programs, first the file is stored in secondary memory. In the execution time, the processor will fetch the file from the secondary memory and it is loaded into the main memory. Processor will get the file, get the instructions from the file, and it is stored in primary memory. Why it will be stored in the primary memory? Because of execution purpose. Always the execution can be done inside the primary memory, that is nothing but the RAM. So these all the points can be tracked by the operating system. Each and everything related to the memory that can be managed by the operating system. So this is the first function of operating system, that is memory management. Second one is process management. Process management. So here process is nothing but the program in execution. Program in execution. Process is different and processor is different. Process is nothing but the it is a program in execution. If you want to execute the any programs, if you want to execute the any task, that can be processed in terms of process, that instructions can be grouped together and it is make it as a one process. So here process management means it has to creating the process, executing the process. So after execution, automatically the process will be destroyed. So why it will be destroyed? Because again it has to take the next process. Again it has to take the next process. For example, if you want to execute the 10 process or 10 instructions, 10 instructions. Okay, so each instruction can be executed by the process. Here process means it consists of a number of instructions. So here it means that one instruction is not one process. Either it may be a process or either it may not be a process, because the instructions can combine to form a process. First it will create the process. After creating the process, it has to execute. At the time of executing the process, either you have to cancel the process, either you have to abort or exit the process. So here process is nothing but the task. Inside the system, the process will be executed. It is not visible by the user. Okay, so this is nothing but the process management. So again, this process management can be managed by the operating system. Next is, third one is device management. Device management. So here device management is nothing but the, so it is the creating the file, creating the directory. So here directory is nothing but the folder. Either you can create the n number of files, either you can modify the n number of files, either you can create the n number of folders, either you can create the n number of subfolders, either you can delete the folder or either you can remove the folder, either you can delete the file or either you can delete the content of the file. So all are comes under the device management. Again, this device management can be managed by the operating system. So it is related to the memory. Okay. So this is device management. And this device consists of files, folders, and softwares related to device. See here, device is nothing but obviously it is a external device. Either it may be the embedded device. For example, if you want to take the printer. First, if you want to purchase the printer, means that printer is connected to the system, so directly will not get the print copy, because you have to install the device driver. Driver is nothing but the software. Device software. Device driver. Their driver is nothing but the particular device software. It can be installed in the system. So when the software is installed, again it consists of files, again it consists of folders that is related to a particular device. When you click on the print button, means this operating system will send the request to the particular device with the help of that communication. Means the operating system will communicate from one device to another device. That is with the help of system calls. System calls are used to communicate between the devices. So this is completely related to the device management. Next one is file management. So here file management means either user can create the file. If you consider the Word, Excel, okay, you can create your own files. You can delete the file. You can modify the file. In the same way, you can create the folder. You can create the subfolders. Okay, so whatever you can perform the operations with the help of file, so that is nothing but the file management. Once the file is created, again it consists of some properties, size of the file, which type of file you are creating, either it may be the programming file, either it may be the text file, either it may be the Excel file, or either it may be the document file, either it may be the PPT, that is PowerPoint presentation. So what type of file you are created? So all the informations are comes under the file management. Again, this file can be managed by the operating system. Next, protection and security. In the system, so you can perform any task. So you can create any files. You can delete any files. That is created by the user, not created by the system. Suppose if you are delete the operating system related files, automatically the system will be crashed. If it is an important file, automatically the system will be crashed. Otherwise, no problem. Okay, so here protection and security means the operating system will give the security to our files, folders, devices, processes, memory, okay, whatever the components are present in the CPU, whatever you can perform the task, that can be secured by the operating system. The operating system will give the protection and security to the system. Okay? So that is nothing but the protection and security. The next topic is types of operating system. So this is the last topic of software concept. So this is the small chapter and is easy. It consists of completely a theoretical part. Okay. So the next topic is types of operating system. So first one is single user operating system. Single user operating system. So the short form of operating system is OS. So single user operating system means at a time one user can use the system. For example, laptop. For example, your personal computer. Okay. So in your personal computer or in your laptop, so it is not possible to use more than one user at a time. because there will be a only one monitor, there will be a only one keyboard, there will be a only one CPU. In the same way, there will be a one laptop. So it is not possible to use the more than one people at a time. So here single user operating system means one user can use the system at a time. The example for single user operating system is Windows, Linux, etc. Even Apple, etc. Second one is batch operating system. Batch operating system. So here batch operating system, the name itself indicates the similar jobs means, for example, if you want to execute the instructions, for example, arithmetic operations means addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So all are comes under the one job. If it is a different one, again it is considered a second group, that is batch. So here batch operating system means it will allow the users to create the batches. So which type of batches? Whatever can perform the operation, the similar type of operations can be grouped. Grouping in the sense, it is nothing but the batch, and it will execute batch wise. So in single user operating system means at a time you can perform the task. Here batch operating system, first you can make the one group, after that you can execute the process. The entire batch considered as a one process. So here one task indicates one process. So here batch means you can store the n number of instructions, n number of similar operations that can be considered as a single process, because it will execute the program batch wise. So that's why it is called as a batch operating system. Types of operating system. First one is single user operating system. Second one is batch operating system. Third one is multi-programming operating system. The name itself indicates the multiple programs. Okay? The operating system will provide to execute the n number of programs at a time. That means it supports the multiple programs to execute. It is nothing but the simultaneously we have to execute the more than one software. For example, if you consider the mobile, so at a time you have to listen the songs and you have to browse the net. That is nothing but the two applications are running in the mobile in the same way system also. Multi-programming operating system means the operating system will provide the environment to execute the multiple programs. Not only two, minimum two, more than two. So that is nothing but the multi-programming operating system. In the same way, multitasking. Multi-programming and multitasking. So here multi-programming means it is considered as a particular program. Multitasking means it is considered as a particular software or particular application. Program means single. Task means n number of programs. Simultaneously you have to execute the more than one process in a system. In the same way, in the system you have to execute more than one task. That is nothing but the multitasking operating system. multitasking operating system. Next is multi-user operating system. See here, single user operating system means only one user can use this system at a time. So here multi-user operating system means n number of users, more than one user use this system at a time. So how it is possible? Because the operating system is installed in system 1. So this is connected to the several terminals. So terminals is nothing but the screen. That is system 2, system 3, system 3, system 4. So at a time, 4 members can use the system. Here, see here, CPU is only one. This CPU is connected to different systems. Means whatever the user one can perform the task, it is stored in CPU 1. At the same time, user 2 can perform another task of the same task, again it is stored in CPU, same CPU. So this is nothing but the multi-user operating system. The name itself indicates, it will give the permission to use the more than one user can use the system. That is nothing but the multi-user operating system. Next is time sharing operating system. So here time sharing operating system is nothing but the, so it refers to the allocation of computer resources to the n number of users. So here computer resources means either it may be the printer, either it may be the scanner. Okay, so resources means the hardware components, not only the keyboard and mouse. Okay, the same keyboard cannot be used at a time more than one user, but printer can be used. So here time sharing operating system means at a time two users can do the print. For example, if you consider the net center, so in the net center there are n number of systems will be there, but it has only one printer. So if you want to work on any system with that system, so you can do the print means directly you can get the printout. So here time sharing operating system means the time will be shared to the different number of users. It is a sharing of resources. So that is nothing but the time sharing operating system. The next is real-time operating system. So real-time operating systems are mainly used in the industries. Okay, so here real-time operating system means, suppose if the event will be occurred, again there are n number of systems will be there, and it is nothing but the client and server. Client is one, n number of clients are there and server is only one. If the person has to send any event messages, automatically it will affect to the remaining system. So real-time operating system means whatever the event has to be occurred, that message will be respond to the other users immediately, not the after event completion. So if the event is generated, the event is nothing but the one task. If the task is generated, automatically it will reaches the other users within the completion of that task. That is nothing but the real-time operating system. Next is network operating system. Network operating system. So we are see here, network means it is a connection of, it is an interconnection of computers. Network operating system means you have to establish the LAN connection. LAN means local area network. And see here, system 1, 2, 3, 4. All the systems are interconnected each other with the help of internet, LAN cable. With the help of LAN, again it is possible to share the files. Again it is possible to share the resources. The main advantage of using the network operating system is it is cost effective, because the sharing of resources will be there in the network operating system. So these 8 are the types of operating system. Next is functional features of operating system. So here the functional features of operating systems are nothing but the first one is CUI. CUI means command line user interface, graphical user interface. So see here, command line user interface means whatever you can perform the task, whatever you can communicate with the system, that is completely with the help of command. The example for CUI is a DOS operating system, that is a disk operating system. In the disk operating system, so whatever you can perform the task, that can be done with the help of commands. Command means it performs some action. For example, presently we are using the GUI, that is graphical user interface. So everything will be icons. Once the system is on, if you want to open the my computer, means directly you can double click on the my computer, but it is not possible in the CUI. Because if you want to open the any drive, means with the help of commands only. With the help of commands you can operate the system. If you want to create the file, again with the help of command. If you want to write the text, again it is with the help of command. If you want to create the folder, if you want to delete the folder, so whatever you can perform the operation, that can be done with the help of command, that is nothing but the CUI, that is command line user interface. Another one is graphical user interface. So as compared to the CUI, it is very easy. Everything will be icons and is more interactive. If you want to open any file, directly you can double click on the particular file. If you want to open the drive, directly you can double click on the particular drive. You can open easily, you can delete easily, you can create easily, you can write. That is nothing but the GUI, that is graphical user interface. So this is completely about the software concept. So it's a complete your software concept chapter. Okay, first chapter is completely about the basic. That is, what is computer? So what are the components of CPU? That is block diagram of CPU, characteristics of CPU, generation, evolution, applications, etc. Next is the data representation chapter. In the data representation chapter, only conversions are there. That is the decimal to binary, decimal to octal, decimal to hexadecimal, and vice versa. In the same way, addition, subtraction, and some computer codes. In the software concept, software, what are the types of softwares? So what are the computer languages? Loaders, linkers, operating system, functions of operating system and types of operating system. Last one is functional features of operating system. So this is completely about the software concept. In the next class, so we'll move to some programming concepts. Okay, thank you.